I did a lot of reading during my time for treatments as a way to try and find and make sense of things. And Lance Armstrong, whether you like him or not, had some wonderful points about fighting cancer. In his book, It's Not About the Bike, It's My Journey Back to Life, I agreed with him. I met a lot of people in Iowa City suffering far greater than I, and I agree with him that the disease does not discriminate or listen to the odds. It can decimate a strong person with a wonderful attitude while it somehow miraculously spares a weaker person who is resigned to failure. As I sit in my treatments, I've observed it's not about worthiness, as I am no more or less valuable than the person sitting next to me in the chemo center. It is, as Armstrong says, the fact that you're staring into a mystery about your future that makes it so significant. To be afraid offers a priceless education, and it makes you know more about yourself and your priorities than most people. Keep your priorities in order and continue to ask more of yourself each day as a person as you take one day at a time. What became so important to me during treatments was my relationship with my friends and brothers on the call committee. And we adopted the verse Joshua 1, 6 through 9 as our verse on the call committee and meditated on that verse weekly. And I adopted that as my strength verse throughout my treatments, particularly verse 9. And that particular verse goes as follows. You'll see it up on the screen. Do not be terrified. Do not be discouraged, for the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go. And how true that is. Throughout the process, I also had a very special relationship with my doctors in Iowa City. One of my favorite doctors, Dr. Klayman, my oncologist, shared with me on April 9th, "Dave, I hate to have to put you through all this, but you'll be rewarded in the end." I quoted Dr. Klayman my favorite verse, 1 Corinthians 9:24. I said, "Dr. Klayman, do you not know that in a race all the runners run, but only one gets the prize? Run in such a way as to get that prize." I told Dr. Klayman that we both want that prize at the end of the game, and that I'm running to win this race. I also continued to read to find more strength in a book by the title Lone Survivor by Marcus Luttrell. Truly inspired me with some of the mental things that I had to go through to fight this fight. Marcus is a U.S. Navy SEAL who had written his book to share his story of survival as he trained as a SEAL and was deployed to Afghanistan in the War on Terror. That particular reading helped me connect with my father, a Marine veteran of the Korean War, and my oldest son, John, a federal agent who have both endured similar training regimens. Marcus asked his instructor, a man who was respectfully referred to by his first name as Reno, about some of the harsh training strategies employed by the Navy SEALs. Reno's reply has stuck with me. He responded, "Marcus, the body can take darn near anything. It's the mind that needs training. Can you cope with the unfairness, that much of a setback, and still come back with your jaw set, still determined and swearing to God you'll never quit? That's what we're looking for." Instructor Reno provided some relevant information for me with regard to carrying my body during those times and how it parallels the rigorous training he endured. I took his advice and stayed mentally tough and determined throughout the process. Yet another connection I made was in the pharmacy in Iowa City. I was there to pick up some prescriptions one day. And as I was sitting in the pharmacy waiting room, a little guy named Taylor, I'd say probably about third grade, was waiting with his mom. He too had cancer. He was fighting leukemia, as I learned when I talked to him. He was playing with a rubber baseball, so that really got my attention right off the bat. And of course, we began to play a game of toss with the rubber baseball. And I had to demonstrate some of my famous baseball tricks I used to play when I was playing Pepper, and he was pretty amused by that. We were having a lot of fun when he looked at me point blank and said, Mister, when are they going to let you go back outside to play? I thought about that, and I shared with little Taylor that I had about 3 weeks of treatments left and some recovery time after that, but then I get to go back out and play. How about you? He looked at his mom, and she said about the same. So we finished our game of toss, wished each other luck on our journeys, and honestly, that conversation put it in perspective for me. I decided I was ready to win this thing and get back outside and play, thanks to Taylor's advice. All throughout my cancer treatments, those who I had made connections with during my journey were praying for me. I certainly experienced some anxious moments, but I was always aware that those who loved me were praying for me and asked God to support me. I began to realize that I still had the greatest blessing of all, and that was God's unconditional love, shown through the support of loved ones and friends. So how do I go about reaching closure in this battle? Well, I'm happy to report that I remain cancer-free following some recent testing in Iowa City, and that I'm doing regular maintenance checks with my team of doctors there to monitor things and deal with some treatment side effects. And my family and I are really excited about that news. As always, I continue to read to try and make sense of things, and a good friend recently suggested The Last Lecture by Randy Pausch. It's a story of a college instructor who had just been diagnosed with an aggressive form of pancreatic cancer and was given 3 months to live. He developed what was called a last lecture designed to tell his story to his three young children, the oldest of which was only five. His concern was that they would not remember him after his passing, and he wanted to share what he felt were some of life's important lessons. Randy's key message was to live in the present and to enjoy what you have. There are always going to be stumbling blocks in life, or what he called brick walls, that you run into. Your task is not to complain about them, but to find ways over, around, and through them. And Randy shared that those brick walls are only there to show how badly we want something, and that they serve to keep those away who really aren't committed to achieving their goals. You know, I'd be very surprised if you didn't focus on your goals that you couldn't achieve them in life. There's probably going to be some failures along the way, but you have to remember that failure equips us to value learning over the appearance of smartness and to relish challenge and effort while using those errors as routes to mastery. Over the past year, I've learned that life is truly an adventure. As a good friend shared a couple of weeks ago, an abundant life is full of adventure, and it may involve some risks and dangers. Don't get stuck and be content to stay put. Step out and enjoy the adventure. You have all been a blessing to me throughout this entire contest, and I'm going to continue to serve you and all of your needs, helping each of one of you realize any individual dreams and goals that you may have. To me, that's important. So to close this morning, as another special friend recently shared with me, our culture is just beginning to be open about cancer and all the tough experiences that go with it. We need to be reminded that tough times connect us to others. That is truly where we can find our strength. But most importantly, by connecting with our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, we can turn those tough times over to Him, as His love for us truly surpasses all peace and understanding. When asked, I simply tell people that God has blessed me with love that is far greater than any struggle I may face. Remember, one of my favorite thoughts, your job won't take care of you when you're sick, your friends will. So, as my favorite hymn says, I was there to hear your morning cry. I'll be there when you are old. I rejoiced the day you were baptized to see your life unfold. Please stay in touch and go the distance with Jesus. He will be that friend who is with us from beginning to the end, even in the darkest of times. I thank you for allowing me the opportunity to share with you this morning, and from my family and I, thanks for all your support. kind acts and prayers over the past year. Romans 12:12 says it all for me. Be joyful in hope, patient in affliction, and faithful in prayer. Thank you.